Hey, what's up, guys? Drew here over at RevHiker Outdoors. I got a couple buddies with me. Got Andrew and Tyler in the back, and we're meeting a friend, Jason. But we are getting ready to do some awesome hiking up in the Adirondacks this weekend. So stick around, guys. We're going to do some pretty cool stuff. Haven't exactly decided which trip we're going to do. We're either going to climb the Colden Trap Dyke, which would be really exciting and pretty challenging, or we're going to do a few of the high peaks, Marcy, Gray, Skylight. So either way, I'll let you know when we figure it out, but stick around. We're going to have some awesome fun on this trip. And I will be showing you guys my ultralight setup, the hammock setup. I know a lot of viewers have been requested for that stuff, to see it on the trail. So you guys will get to see that. So stick around. I'll catch you later.
All right, guys. So we just hit the trail, and you can see we got Andrew, Jason, and Tyler behind me. And what a beautiful day. It's high 70s and low humidity. It's going to be an awesome trip. So this first part of the trail is kind of boring until we get into the Marcy Dam and stuff. I'll show you that. Oh, and we decided that we're going to do the Mount Colden Trap Dyke. So it's going to be a really exciting trip. I've got a new head mount for the GoPro, so should get some really cool shots coming up there. So stick around, guys. Here we are at the Marcy Dam. Well, what used to be the dam. It used to be a big bridge here that got taken out by flood, but as you can see, it is a beautiful day. About as good as you can ask for. Actually, if you see, right up there is kind of where we're headed. We're gonna climb that whole slide. Can't really see the trap dike from here, but we're gonna follow those slides all the way up to the summit. So Tyler, it's your first time hiking. How do you like it?
Love it.
Well, we'll awesome. See. We'll see how much you like it if you're freezing tonight.
Yeah, I brought enough clothes.
That's good. Well, not gonna be able to stay here tonight. I'll leave that behind.
Wow.
Success, boys. This one's empty. Okay, so third time's a charm. We checked out two other lean-tos, and they were straight up packed. Well, you saw the one there that was full of fairly dirty hippies up here, apparently. Anyway, this is actually, if you guys have been following the channel for a long time and you're quite astute, this is the exact same lean-to I stayed in when I did the McIntyre Range. With those two guys that I met from Pittsburgh, and so this is where I met them, and we've been doing hikes every year since. But anyway, we're going to be setting up. I'll show you guys some video of us setting up, but Tyler's going to be here in the lean-to. Jason's got a hammock like me, so I'll show you his setup. Andrew's going to be in a little solo tent, and we'll show you guys the camp if it's all set up. So far, good grief. The daylight, the Mountain Smith daylight, has been great with these pack mods that I made, putting on the shoulder straps and the straps on the bottom. So anyway, I'm sure you guys will see more of that in the upcoming stuff. So stick around. Andrew's going to be in this little Eureka solitaire. He got this off of me. This used to be mine. Good little tent. Good little tent for sure. And Jason's in here putting the finishing touches on his hammock set up. He's got the Eno Housefly tent, along with, I think it's their Helios straps or whatever they are. You got the Guardian bug net, and then he's got his hammock down in there. I can't recall the name of it, but it's the one where you
reactor
where you slip the sleeping pad in there. So he's just finishing up his suspension there. If you guys remember from the review, this is my Grand Trunk Funky Forest tarp. I set it up a little different. I had a couple guys say, oh, you should try it with the loops on top. So that's what I'm doing for this trip. I'm trying it instead of having the ridgeline underneath. And you can see we've got a lot of room here. So this is quite high. I can just about stand up straight in this. Got to bend my head over a little bit. And then my normal setup here, I got the Guardian. And when I lay in this, this ridgeline tightens up significantly. I got it pretty much perfect. I really like the pitch on it. So this is our little camp here. And I'm in between a couple of birch trees. And the only problem here is that we've got lines here. Got my lines here. Got his lines here. So in the middle of the night, if I need to get up, I'm going to put my headlamp to good use because I don't need to be tripping over 9 hammock lines and, you know, going crash in the night. So anyway, guys, that's camp setup. Thought you might want to watch. Oh, Jason brought one of these cool little Helinox chairs. Super cool. About ready to come out to Avalanche Lake. If you haven't seen this portion of Adirondacks, I strongly recommend coming out. It is awesome. Easy hike, and the views are worth it. That's not bad at all, huh?
Doesn't get much better than that. Doesn't get much better than that.
Beautiful day, too. We are back at camp, and we were cooking some meat, but now it's in his hand. Anyway, we're about to get dinner rolling, and just gonna hang out until we go to sleep. And we got back to the lean-to. We went and explored Avalanche Pass a little bit, and met a couple cool guys, Darren and Caleb. Say hey, guys.
Hi. Hey.
They're gonna be sharing with us tonight. And anyway, it's gonna be cool, so stick around, guys.
Now I got a question for you guys.
Yes, go away.
Does anybody have another pot, or is this the only one we got?
That's the largest pot. I've got my own little pot here.
All right, well this is my dilemma.
Okay.
I have enough to make 2 portions, but normally you make it in a big pot.
Right.
I only have a little pot. So I can do 2 half portions. I guess that's, I'm forced to do 2 halves or see how much we got. And...
I got tinfoil too, by the way.
You got a whole sheet of tinfoil.
I do too. It's just folded up for a windscreen.
Don't make excuses.
Stop being a jerk. Just going back. You got me all higgledy piggledy here, making fun of me. All right, guys, so you know that I'm a fan of like minimalist food and stuff like that, but Jason, this is my first time backpacking with Jason. Jason's not a fan of minimalist anything, really. He's in a chair. He's got like a full set of everything. He's cutting up onions right now. He's cutting up onions. He's got like his table set up over here. He's boiling pasta. He's slicing up onions.
Got tomatoes.
He's like making us casserole for dinner, and I'm sitting here with like my DIY dehydrated chili that's not rehydrated yet. And, you know, I'm bringing Tyler on his first overnighter, and I'm feeling like a total failure. And I'm not sure whether to invite Jason again because he'll cook me something good, or to not invite him because he's showing me up. Either way, if the casserole sucks,
I'm not invited.
Yeah, yeah. Then I'll feel like I'm a little bit redeemed. So, your water's boiling. Pour that into your stuff. All right, we'll check in later. I'll let you know if my dehydrated chili was a total bust or not.
Good flavor.
Okay, guys, so I just tried my dehydrated chili, and I didn't even make homemade chili because I just ran out of time. So I bought some junky canned chili and dehydrated it, and it was actually really good. But I'm still looking at Jason here, like sauteing onions and ground beef. And as good as this chili is, I can't help but feel a little inadequate. Sit rep. The chili was good. It's already given me some gas, though. I don't feel good. Stomach hurts. And then Jason finished this stuff. Was it a casserole you called it?
Yeah.
It's really good.
Basically lasagna.
It's like trail lasagna. It's super good. He brought cheese and raw meat and noodles and, you know, straight up went emerald over there. Yeah, onions, the whole nine. So probably the best I've eaten on the trail in a very long time. So the trip could end right now, like with a bear attack, and I'd still be happy because the food was that good. So catch you later. All right, guys, so this will be kind of the last thing before go to bed here, but got my setup and got my pack hanging from my hammock suspension here. We had an awesome dinner, great hike, and I'm looking forward to tomorrow and looking forward to a good night's sleep in my Eno setup here. So I'll catch you guys in the morning, and in the morning we are going to go through some awesome trails by Avalanche Pass, just some really, really cool stuff. And then climbing the trap dike is gonna be really cool and probably more than a little sketchy in points, so I definitely gonna wanna stick around and check that out. I saved my GoPro battery, so I'll be able to do a lot of that when we're climbing some cliffs and going through the waterfalls and stuff. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. All right, guys, so it's the morning. We had a good night. Everybody's just kinda packing up camp. I'm all packed up, and everyone else is just about done, so we're just getting ready, making up some breakfast. Got some oatmeal on the way, and I already had a couple of these suckers, the imitation something. Oops, sorry, I got a little fogged up there. But anyway, just boiling up some water, and had a good night's sleep. Feet got a little cold. It got down into the mid to upper 40s last night. And anyway, I'll catch you guys when we're on the trail going through Avalanche Pass, because it's some pretty cool stuff. So I'll check in then. All right, we're heading out for day two. Everyone's eating. We're all ready. And we're hiking with our new friends back here, Darren and Caleb. We're going to have a good time. They're going to go out to the end of Avalanche Lake with us and then go their separate ways. But anyway, stick around. It's going to be a lot of fun today. All right, guys, so now we are on the trail that skirts the side of Avalanche Lake. That's where we were taking pictures last night. And now this trail is pretty cool. It's a lot of boulders, and then there's a lot of ladders and walkways, and I'll definitely show you it all. It's pretty awesome trail. So hopefully I don't fall and snap anything. You trying to pass me, Jason?
Trying to pass all of us.
See how it is. Oh, go ahead. You don't have to be a team player. It's cool. There it is, first ladder.
Oh,
Tyler just snapped an ankle. All right.
Camera going?
Oh, I got the camera going. I'm waiting for you to get up to that ledge. Give out like a Tarzan roar. Look, Jason going for the pass again. Going for the pass again. Go ahead, guys. I guess I better try this now. Let's see if I could do this with the camera and not die. All right, guys, I'll check in as we go. I'll video when it's safe, because I don't really want to die out here or snap anything, but I'm gonna have the GoPro on a new head mount that I made for the trap dyke. Check this out real quick. Super cool. But I'm gonna have a little head mount on the GoPro, so kind of get some POV on what it's like on some of these climbs through some waterfalls and stuff like that. So I hope you guys are enjoying this. I know I'm having a blast. Check in later. How you guys doing? Say hi, you're on YouTube.
Hi.
Have a good one, guys. Alright, guys, so this might be my favorite part of this trail. Let's see.
It's right over the water.
Kind of bolted into this rock face. Such a cool trip. Very important to look a little rocky. Sorry, I gotta look where I'm going instead of focusing on this camera. I wanna take a digger here. All right, so we're heading along Avalanche Lake here on my favorite trail, and we're getting our first views of the trap dyke. We have to go down to that end of the lake, walk back along that shore, and then we begin the ascent up through that little canyon or trap dyke. So I'll get a better view of it in a few minutes. All right, so here is a shot of the trap dyke. Try to zoom in there. We are going to be climbing this whole thing. We'll be getting out near the top of that and then climbing a slide all the way to the top. Sorry about that. Anyway, it's going to be awesome. But that's what you guys are in store for. Stick around and see if we make it. All right, so we are nearing the base of the trap dyke, and this trail is well, not much of a trail really. This is not an official trail. It's a little more than a herd path, but it's traveled enough to where you can, I gotta make a jump here, hold on. That slammed shut. It's traveled enough to where you can pick out the path. But anyway, okay, here we are, pretty much at the base of it. This is all the rubble at the bottom.
All right, we are at the base of the trap dike here. We're over there. You can actually see one of those really cool bridges that we were on over there, bolted right to the face of the rock. Anyway, we hiked all the way down, got to that end, and came back. And we're just kind of getting a drink and waiting to try to climb this. This is pretty impressive. Actually, I'll try to zoom in. There's one guy ahead of us. Sorry for the unsteady camera here. But you can see it's a bit of a scramble. Gonna be a challenge. So we're just gonna say a quick word of prayer and then head up. So Jason, why don't you go ahead and lead us in a quick prayer, man? Go for it.
Lord God, we thank you for today. We thank you for the fellowship, Lord. We pray, God, that you'd keep your hand of protection upon us, Lord. Lord, and we pray, God, that you'd help us to accomplish your purpose and your will. In Jesus' name.
Amen. All right, let's be off.
All right.
All right, guys, so we've been climbing for maybe 20 minutes now, and we came a long way. So, man, this is one of the coolest climbs I have ever been on. We've still got a long way to go, but we're just taking a little break here, gonna water up. A couple guys are getting a snack. This is kind of one of the tricky parts, but I think we can take, that's like a little staircase there, and then cut over, and then back up there. Whew.
How you guys doing? You liking this?
Great. Love
awesome.
It.
Awesome. What do you think?
Beautiful. This is unreal. Absolutely unreal.
This is pretty legit. This is a great hike. This is one that I have to come back and do again, for sure. So this is going to be the absolute hairiest part of the climb. That is going to be near vertical up there. This is going to be great, man. I really hope these GoPro videos are taken. And look, guys, I know this is going to be a long video, but truthfully, I don't care. I'm recording this for my own satisfaction as much as I am to put it on YouTube. This is going to be fun. I really hope you guys are enjoying this. This is pretty awesome adventure. Well, we came from all the way down there and we're up kind of the first half of the pretty sketchy part, and you can see Jason's on the final part of the really steep section.
Yeah, no, take your
time. Man, this is cool.
Here we go.
Thank you.
we all made it up the sketchy spot. The seriously sketchy spot. Yeah. This has just been awesome. There's that bridge again. Way down there. Whew. Now, this is the first spot where you can get on the slide and take the slide all the way up to the summit. But if you get off here, it's gonna be too steep. So we're gonna head up a little farther. Sorry about into the sun there. We're gonna head up there a little ways, hop on the slide, and scoot up to the summit.
Slimy. All right, so we're still on our way up. We haven't exited yet, but just wanted to give you guys some views of where we came from down there. Now, if you look here, that is Algonquin. That's the second highest peak in New York. There's Boundary Peak, a thing that looks kind of like two lumps there. And then that's Iroquois. And I think Iroquois is number 11, maybe? Something like that. Either way, and then this little one right here is called Avalanche. You can just kind of see it back there. But man, look at these canyons. These cliff faces are awesome. This is a very, very cool hike. Now I gotta play catch up. Yeah, so these are our views here, talking to the camera, and we're gonna head up the slide now. I got a guy that just passed us. He's cheating though, he's got climbing shoes, and we're gonna head up and see you guys at the top. This will give the old glutes a workout. Andrew, you don't have to pour that out. You can just cap it so it won't leak.
Oh, okay.
And then it won't lose its prime. taking our lunch break. Well, Jason isn't. He's been feasting on the way up. Man. It actually, because of the pitch, you can't see where we started. It drops off and it's too steep, so there's just kind of this ridge that you see. But we've come a long way up the slide. But it's really not far to the top. I think the summit's just a couple 200-300 yards from here. Check in when we get to the top. All right, we finally made it off of the slide. Now we're in this scrub brush, and there's somewhat of a trail worked out. Let's do it. Okay, guys, so we successfully navigated the trap dike and the new slide. Got up to the top. You guys are standing on the summit. It has been a challenging but very rewarding hike. It's hard to see. Mount Marcy is in the back there, tallest peak in New York. And man, great time. Now we've only got like, 6 or 8 miles out. So should be easy.
I'll take that any day.
Whew, check in later.
Hey, I think your raincoat's.
Coming down from the summit of Colden after we did the trap dike, we're going back down the normal trail because the trap dike is just kind of too much. Really can't down climb it, especially that slide. And somebody lugged all of this wood all the way up here. Pretty impressive. What I want to show you is the slide above the trap dike where we climbed. That's it. You just see that ribbon of rock. That's the slide that we went up. So it's pretty steep. Anyway, I just thought that was cool. It's a kind of a nice view of the slide. And pretty much a nice view of most of the major ranges in the Adirondacks.
Where am I looking?
Well, we're on the trail out now, and we've got maybe a little under 3 miles. Oop, almost fell there. We had a great hike. It was awesome. I really hope you guys enjoyed coming along. I know we had a blast. We're definitely a little tired. It was pretty, that slide was pretty physically demanding. That was a pretty rough trail. But we had a blast, and just a couple reports. As far as my hammock system, loved it. The tarp was great, bug net, everything was nice. I slept really well. This pack has been great with the modifications where I was able to put all my sleep stuff on the outside. It was great. And
I was able to compress that strap on my tarp and everything and the hammock even more. And I was able to stuff that in the bottom of the bag with my cook set next to it, and I made even more room. So definitely opened up a lot of space with that. We had a blast. We're definitely going to be getting back together again, do some more hikes. And anyway, guys, I really appreciate you coming along. Maybe we'll might get a couple more shots on the way out when we get to the vehicle, or maybe I'll do some drifting in the old Subaru. But anyway, guys, thanks for coming along. I'll check back in one more time before we're out. All right, guys, well, that's it. We're back at the car, the old Subaru there, and we're saying goodbye to our friend Jason. So, man, it's been good hiking with you. Thanks for coming along, and definitely have these guys along again and try to get another trip report video out to you guys. We had an absolute blast. Thanks for coming, guys. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe. God bless you guys, and I will see you later.